Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Let me introduce myself. My name is Jessica Emanuela. I am an active student majoring in public relations at Alas PR Communication and Business Institute Jakarta under the supervision of Mr. Charles Bonar Sirait as my mentor and my lecturer. Today, I'm going to talk to you about problems that are currently being discussed everywhere, namely good health and well-being and sustainable development goals or SDGs number 3, focus on mental health. Let's discuss this problem. The history of the SDGs cannot be separated from the Millennium Development Goals, or commonly called the MDGs, which ended in December 2015. The end of the MDGs was the beginning for countries in the world to formulate a new platform to continue a noble goal. On 2 August 2015, at the United Nations headquarters in New York, by acclamation, 193 United Nations member countries are adopted a document entitled Transforming Our World, the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. The meeting was followed by the Sustainable Development Summit, and the meeting success in ratifying a document called Sustainable Development Goals or SDGs, which contain 17 goals and is divided into 169 targets to make human life better. From the 17 goals that have been set, I will now discuss one of the goals, namely goal number 3 on ensuring healthy life and supporting well-being for all ages. One of the targets is 2030 reduce one-third of premature death caused by non-communicable disease through preventive and curative measures and promoting mental health and well-being. Focus on mental health. What do you think of when you hear people about people with mental disorder? A scary person or people roaming the street? Maybe that's the thing that come to mind when people hear people with mental disorder. Although it's not always like that. Mental disorder are very diverse. Even in our daily life, we can experience them. Mental health problems are everyone's problem. Currently, mental health issues are being discussed everywhere, from influencers, artists, or even in the media. Even now, there are so many campaign, communities, and social media that voice about mental health. Discussions like this are good, meaning that people are starting to become aware of what is called mental health. What is mental health? According to the World Health Organization, we can be said to have a healthy mentality if firstly we realize our potential, secondly we can face the normal stress found in everyday life, thirdly we can work productively, and fourthly when we can make a good contribution to society. The point is when we can live our life optimally. Mental health is like a spectrum. When we talk about mental health, we cannot talk about people from the black and white side, meaning we cannot classify people all with between two states, namely sick or healthy. The spectrum is made up of a line that has a right side and a left side, and our position determines which side are we on. We are definitely in this line, and our position can change. When we can buy the things that really want, we will feel happy and excited. Finally, we will be more productive, and our mental health condition is on the right, which is mentally healthy. But when the next day, the item that was purchased yesterday is lost, we will feel sad and have trouble concentrating, which put us on the left side of the spectrum. But it also be that when we are on the left spectrum, we are experiencing mental disorder, for example, depression, anxiety disorder, or etc. So when we talk about mental health, conditions are very dynamic and changing. But it's very normal if we are on the left spectrum. But people who are on the left spectrum are stigmatized as weak people. Even though this is normal, it's okay not to be okay. How do we know if our mental health disorder are normal or have entered the stage of needing help? The thing we should avoid is self-diagnosing by reading information from the internet, because our judgment can sometimes be wrong and even make things worse. The most correct way is we have to go to a mental health expert, namely a psychologist or psychiatrist. They are the one who can provide us a diagnosis whether we have a mental health disorder or not, and provide the best solution for us. The stigma or bad value given to people with mental health in Indonesia is obtained through the influence of a bad environment. Labeling, exclusion, and stereotypes against people with mental health disorder make people who suffer from mental disorder choose to remain silent or not consult an expert. As a result, based on data from Riskcast 2018, 12 million people aged over 15 years experienced depression, and 19 million people over 15 years experienced mental emotional disorders. Bad stigma about mental health in Indonesia is still common. This is what makes people with mental disorder feel afraid to take action and feel hopeless. Let's stop the stigma about people with mental health disorder. So, when we feel something is wrong with us, especially in the midst of pandemic like this, which according to data from the Ministry of Health, where the rate of people with mental disorder is increasing due to the unexpected change, don't be afraid to go out to a psychologist and ask for help, because going to a psychologist doesn't mean we are crazy. Don't be ignorant of our own mental health, because our mental health is very influential on various aspects, such as our physical health, our relationship with others, and also the closest people in our lives. That's all for me. Thank you so much for your attention.